Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. And today you can see I'm in my camp, and again I have my friend Tristan with me. And we are having a little plan here to make something a little bit later. So hang on. I hope you like that too. But as you saw in my first of this video, I actually was out here in my camp a couple of days ago. It was raining, but I had to start a project. And of course, as you can see, it's a little spoon that I've been carving. And back home, I have finished it. I'll show you in close-up in a minute. And the reason why I made this is because I got such one. And this one is a coffee pouch from a company called Lemel. And in here, there's a new kind of coffee that I have never tasted before, and it is whiskey coffee. And I'll tell you a little bit about that too in a moment. And beside that, I made a little new canister for my salt, which I always put in my coffee. So now I'll show you in detail how this looks and tell you a little bit about the new kind of coffee that I'm going to make today. And this is a coffee pouch filled with whiskey coffee grains. When you get the coffee, it is in beans, so you have to grind it yourself in the right coarse grind. So, and this is my new coffee pouch, and this is my new spoon, which I was started up here, as you saw in my beginning of this video. So, this is my new coffee spoon, and I think it's, well, it's looking all right. I made it from birch again, and this time I used mineral oil instead of olive oil, and that's why it's so white, because mineral oil doesn't color the wood as much as sunflower oil or olive oil, and I think it's suits it very nice. And beside that, I made such a one. I made a few of those, but in here I have salt for my coffee and a little cork and just something for decoration here. So this is my new coffee set. Of course I'll use the other one too. And this whiskey coffee, well, the beans are roasted, and then I think they are roasted, and then they are put in some empty used whiskey barrels, and the beans are kept there for some months, and then it is I think it's roasted after that. I'm not sure, but the beans has been in whiskey barrels and have taken a lot of the taste, the flavor from the whiskey. And when you smell it, it's really strong smell of whiskey, and I like that very much. But the company tells me that you're supposed to blend it with ordinary coffee because it's very strong whiskey taste. I haven't decided now. I haven't decided yet what I'm going to do. Am I going to make a strong, very strong whiskey coffee and see how that is tasting? Or am I going to blend it with some coffee? I think I'll try it strong and see what happens. If I think it's too strong, then I'll make it with a little bit of ordinary coffee the next time. And for those of you who like my, love my little whiskey wink, don't worry. Regardless how this whiskey is tasting, of course I'll put a little, you know, sip of this wonderful whiskey in. So now it's time for making a fire, so we can put on the kettle. And when I have got my coffee and I have some cocoa for Tristan, then we are going to use some of the embers from the fire to make something similar like this. Yeah, some of you maybe have guessed this already. We're going to make spoons by burning them. It's an old school way to do it, and I've seen it. Other YouTubers do that. I never tried myself, but today Tristan and I are going to try to make two spoons by burning the hole down in the wood. So very excited for that. Hope you like. Tristan are going to make a fire today in a new way we haven't done before, with the magnifying glass. And in this little canister from Hudson Bay Company in here. Some of you know that there is a magnifying glass here, and we're going to make a fire only using this. I think it'll work. The sun is strong today, and I have some good tinder. So, a little bit exciting. Sometime it's going to begin smoking, and that's just before it's going to burn. Det vil lige prøve noget andet. Instead of the yew twine, we'll try with some birch bark. But that's easier.
Er det?
Ja, det prøver vi at se. Ja. Sådan kan det altså godt.
Mm-hmm. Ja, men det ser, jeg må lige prøve noget.
Ja. Vi prøver igen så.
Det er der noget succes.
And we have smoke?
But no fire.
Not yet. Well, now there's a cloud. I think we're going to make it the old school way with fire steel. Yeah.
That is the only way.
Så på, lige der. Sådan der. Der var det. Super godt. Ja. Cool. That's awesome.
That is the only way to do it.
We did it. That's the main thing. We did it. Yeah.
It was a lot easier in that.
Than the magnifying glass, that's right.
That, no.
So, now for the first time, I'm going to taste the whiskey coffee from Lemmel, and as they said to me, perhaps it's too strong flavor, so blend it with some ordinary Lemmel coffee, but I didn't do that, so now it's on me. And the smell here is very special. Yeah, let me taste. Yeah, it do taste like whiskey, but it's not too strong. I think it's okay. And actually, we can add a little bit. So we have my doubled whiskey coffee. Skål. Ah, it's nice. And you have something with you, Tristan. What is this? Yellow? What is this, the yellow thing?
Nothing. Ah,
it's the traditional cake we always have with us when we out here. And lemon moon, we are calling them in Denmark. And yeah, this is tradition. Tristan always brings such a one. And we love it, both of us. So we have to cut it up in pieces. And for that purpose, you have a dagger?
Yes.
Yes. Do you want to, a knife? Do you have a knife you can cut it with? You fetch it yourself, then I open this. Okay. You can take it up here. Oh, that's what. Yummy. Yummy, yummy. In my tummy. And Tristan didn't want hot chocolates, hot cocoa, so perhaps we do that later. But now, da-da, you cut a piece for me and a piece for you. Very, very good coffee. Mmm. Thank you. And I don't think it's too strong whiskey taste. But again, I'm a tough person regarding whiskey in your coffee. So perhaps that's why. When you grind it, it's a very intense flavor you get of whiskey. And of course, if you don't like the smell of whiskey, it's not good, but I like it, I love it, so for me this is the ultimate coffee, I can tell you. So very nice, and with a lid of cake too. Mm. Skål, Tristan. You have a water bottle somewhere. Until later. Mm. Mm. Thank you.
No, man.
That'll do. You're gonna make a deepen here as a spoon, and instead of using a hook knife or spoon knife, we're gonna make some coals. Use some coals. And I think if I make a little hole here, maybe the coals will be more secured on this. Not much, but enough that a little piece of charcoal here placed there.
Yeah.
Then you take this one and you just blow it, and then it should be burning down in this. And if the coals are not working, we'll take some new. You got a lot of smoke in yours. That's cool. Really cool. It's
burning down.
It's so beautiful. You're good at this, Tristan. And it doesn't surprise me, you're good at anything, everything out here. I would say anything that has fire in it. And if it's a little bit out, just put it back.
Du puster altså for langt over for mig.
I'm sorry.
That I made by chair. That.
Yeah. Piece of dead wood.
And this is yours.
Yeah, and it's not. It's not as deep as yours. I know. You are very good at this, Tristan. Again.
Maybe I'm lucky.
No, you have a good. You have a good technique. And then you're going to. Let me see. Carve it out with your knife. Just clean it. Yeah, and I know.
And I'm making a spoon of it.
Yeah. Perhaps stone here will be better. Try with the stone here. See if you can. How does it look? Let me see.
Pretty good.
Yes. Where is it? I have to focus on it. There. Just a moment. Yeah, you can see.
But it's not finished, I mean.
No, finished yet.
A lot of.
Yeah.
Just.
A lot of work yet. But you're working hard on it, Tristan. It's so cool. I love your enthusiasm. Cut it rough for Tristan so that it's easier to make the. Just so it takes a little bit shape of a spoon. Yeah. And then my knife, where is it? There. Let me take this one. Let's hang it down here. Here. Nice. Can we see how it looks now? Or is it too early? Yeah, a little bit down there. There you see. It's going to be a cool little spoon.
Den spoon, som jeg brugte endnu længere tid på at lave end den her, den er den allerede flottere end den. Mm. Jeg faktisk også tror, jeg har smidt ud, faktisk.
Okay.
Jeg har vel ikke brugt den. Jeg har ikke lavet på den meget, meget lang tid. Sådan. Mm. Rigtig lang tid.
Make it deeper.
Nu føles den faktisk okay at holde i.
That's nice. May we see it, Tristan? See how it's... We are packing and going home in a moment. I would like to show my viewers how cool a project you made there. Yes. A little bit closer, please, and then I'll just handle. Oh, look at this. Isn't it nice? There's a little bit work yet, but he's come far today. And compared with mine, that was a total failure, this one is a success. It's so cool.
Well, folks, this is all for now. Hope you enjoyed this little video with Tristan and myself out here in the camp and making a spoon in the old-fashioned way. It's so cool, and Tristan's spoon got really awesome and mine just a failure. I didn't succeed in burning a very deep hole here. So thank you again for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye. Take care.